Hey, new Adele song. I'm really excited about this one. I'll play just a little bit of it, teach it to you right afterwards. Cool. So that's a little bit of the what you hear in the intro, and then also through the verses and different other instrumental parts of the song. So let me explain what's going on here. Right hand, pretty easy. D, D sharp, 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 and then C and G sharp at the same time. Back up to the D sharp, C and G sharp, three times in a row. Then it goes up to G sharp, D sharp, and G. By the way, if this is too bad a stretch, you could always just do the top two notes. But it sounds a little cooler if you throw in all three. Then G and D, G and B. Good. Left hand, what I'm doing, is going from a C chord to a G sharp to an F chord three times in a row. Then it throws in the G sharp chord to a G chord. All right, so all together we have. Oh, and by the way, at the very, very beginning, you hear this little thing go as it starts off the piano part. Then right into that D sharp there. And it goes kind of like that. Just a quick run. G sharp to the F. Cool. So then it goes again. One more time. G sharp to F. Here we are into this next part. Then it gets into the verse doing the exact same thing. Cool. So you hear that going through the verse. When it gets to the chorus is the next part. Let me get into that. It stays pretty much the same. Timing changes just a little bit. So this one goes four times. Two, three, four. So G sharp with the D sharp still in the right hand. To the F. Then to the G. Good. So what it sounds like with with her singing, and I will sound nothing like Adele, I promise. I wish I did, but anyway, it'll kind of sound like this when it's sung along. When the sky falls and it crumbles, we will stand tall, face it all together, let the sky fall. That's the next part that's going. So let me outline that. Let's see if I have a sheet for that. All right, so for this one, what might sound good is like putting on a string setting. Let me put on strings real quick on my piano. So it would kind of sound like this with strings. Cool, that gives you kind of the effect. Here I'm going same chords in the left hand. Right hand is going G, G sharp, A, G sharp. And I'm doing octaves here. If you can't quite reach it, I mean, it would be okay to play one note at a time. Sounds a little cooler with octaves, all right? So. That goes again. Third time. Alright, then it goes to that G sharp with the C in the right hand. G in the left hand to up to a D in the right. Cool. Then it goes back into the chorus. The last part that you have is kind of a bridge where it really just hangs on one chord. It hangs on that C chord. It's actually a C minor. I've been labeling it as C all along, but you kind of have a bridge where it just kind of hangs on. You kind of have some of those kind of sound effects. It's kind of hanging on that C minor, and then one of the ones I heard was C, D sharp, G, F sharp, G, kind of hangs there. Then it goes right back into the chorus again. So those are the parts of the song. Amazing, cool song. Can't wait for the movie, and I really like the song. So anyway, hope it helped. Thank you for watching. See you later.